what's going on, everyone? My name is Prestige. Today we just got another big update on Call of Duty Black Ops 3 that buffed a few weapons and nerfed our Vesper. So we're going to talk all about that here today in this video. If you want to check out the stuff for yourself, I'll put a link down below in the description so you can go ahead and follow along or read it at your own pace. There were a couple zombie updates as well, which we'll cover, but most of what I want to talk about today are the buffs that happened to a couple of our specialist characters as well as weapons. So let's go ahead and start with our specialists. There were buffs to Outrider, Nomad, and Prophet. Outrider has an increased ability to hit enemies with the Sparrow, and Prophet also got the same exact buff, increased ability to hit enemies with the Tempest. So if you're just a little bit off, you're going to notice that you're going to be landing more shots with your Tempest and your Sparrow more than you would before. Even if you're just a little bit off, you're going to have a better chance of hitting them. Nomad received another buff to Rejack, increasing the remaining power when a player terminates, meaning if you just go ahead and die, then you're going to go ahead and just have an increased power as opposed to what there was before. Now let's move into the bread and butter of what this video is all about, and that is weaponry. We have had an update to assault rifles in the past, but we've also just got another update to assault rifles. The ICR, the HVK30, the Shiva, and the KN44 all received updates. The ICR received an update to its long distance damage range, meaning that its damage at a range is going to be increased. Same thing with the HVK30, and the same thing with the Shiva, meaning you're going to get a lot more headshots with the Shiva while using your high caliber attachment, which is going to be really cool. The KN44 received a buff as well, increased medium distance damage range, which is pretty interesting considering the KN44, to me at least, is one of the best assault rifles that you could use in this game. Moving down to submachine guns, the Vesper actually received a nerf. Reduced recoil stability and reduced hipfire accuracy, meaning that there's going to be a little bit more recoil and the hipfire is going to be a little wider, so it's going to be a little bit harder to get kills with that specific weapon. And I know that this isn't the update that you guys want to hear, but the Weevil did actually receive a buff, at least in hardcore modes. It increased the medium distance damage range in hardcore modes, so if you're using the Weevil in hardcore, you're going to get a lot more medium range kills a lot faster, so those one-shot kills are there to stay. Now finally, with sniper rifles, the Locust received an update, but not to its damage or rate of fire or anything. It got an increase to weapon switch speed, so if you're rocking a secondary weapon, an overkill weapon, or whatever, you can go ahead and swap out weapons a little bit faster. Some updates that were actually included with the last patch have made it into the patch notes here today. So the Power Core actually received a buff, meaning that it's going to be a little bit easier to obtain. 50 points easier. It's only going to cost 1250 now. It's got a duration that was increased to 1 minute instead of, I believe, 30 seconds or 45 seconds. So 60 seconds is what it's going to have now. And then there was also an issue where the Power Core would occasionally fail to destroy an enemy counter UAV. That was fixed within this update as well. Now, I think everybody's biggest concern was with the map Splash. There was some exploits on that map that allowed people to basically get up on top of everything and kind of make their way out of the map, and that's been fixed. Most of it's been fixed. Hopefully, all of the major ones have been fixed, and if there's anything else, it's going to be super hard to get into, and I just hope that that stuff is all addressed by now, and that's at least what it says in this update here. And then finally, while carrying the uplink drone, you'll actually have no aim assist. Before, there was some aim assist and it made it easy for people just to run around with the drone and go around and hit people, because people play the game a little bit differently here. Now they just play uplink to take the drone around and hit people as opposed to taking it and scoring, because what they want to do is just get their score streaks a little bit faster. I don't know, the game mode kind of sucks now because of that, but people play the game how they want to play the game, I suppose. But there is no more aim assist while carrying the uplink drone. Now finally, in this update, there was actually a lot of fixes for zombie mode. Not just Der Eisendrache, it's actually just a fix for Shadows of Evil as well, and some general fixes overall. I won't go through all of them, but there were some issues with like quick revive. There was issues with Pack-a-Punch, there was issues with glitches and stuff like that that were fixed. If you want to check them all out, once again, there's a link down below in the description. I hope you guys enjoyed this quick video today. If you did, make sure to click that like button down below. Do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. And tomorrow, I'm going to have a lot of awesome videos, so stay tuned for that. Until tomorrow then, I'll see ya. Peace! Oh, hey there! Thank you so much for joining me at the end of the video. If you missed yesterday's video, we did the 800,000 subscriber Q&A. Make sure to click on the annotation right now to check that out. And below, you can find a link to my second channel where we actually talked a little bit about Tony Hawk Pro Skater 5. Is it a good game or is it poopy? I'm gonna go with poopy. It's pretty bad. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe to the second channel. And until tomorrow, I'll see ya.